Recently, a woman by the name of Rita Palma, the New York State Director for RFK Jr.'s presidential campaign, suggested that he could serve as a spoiler for Joe Biden. Now, you wouldn't think that considering how Donald Trump has attacked RFK Jr. on a few occasions. But nonetheless, here's what she said to a group of Republican voters. You do have to only pick one candidate at the end of the day, but the Kennedy voter and the Trump voter, our mutual enemy is Biden. She continues to say, see, Bobby right now, he's pulling from both sides. Right now, he's actually pulling a little bit from Biden, which
a little bit more from Biden,
which explains why the DNC is kind of ganging up on him. I actually haven't seen that. And the polling that I've seen indicates that RFK Jr. is pulling voters from Trump. But I mean, things could have changed since then.
No, it's very variable. I've seen both. Mm-hmm. And so I don't think it's clear at all yet. In the beginning, he was pulling more from Trump. Mm-hmm. But now when they include him in the choices, which they should, because he's gonna be on the ballot in many states, then Biden winds up being down by even more. But it's a couple of points. Now, those couple of points are super important in the general election. But you can see why there's complexity in this case. We'll talk more about it in a sec.
So she continues to say, if the Republicans face, well, I guess, accepted the fact that most of the Northeast is going to go blue, why wouldn't we put our vote to Bobby and at least get rid of Biden and get those 28 electoral votes in New York? Give those 28 electoral votes to Bobby rather than to Biden, thereby reducing Biden's 270 electoral votes. And we all know how that works, right? 270 wins the election. If nobody gets to 270, then Congress picks the president. Who are they gonna pick if it's a Republican Congress? They'll pick Trump. So the RFK Jr. campaign has condemned these statements. They say that they don't agree with what she's saying here. We'll get to those statements in just a moment, but I wanted to get that out of the way and let you know it's not a campaign strategy that's being put out by RFK Jr. But nonetheless, what do you think about what she's saying here, Cenk?
Pausing here to deliver some honest truth as we do in our news coverage as well. TYT is facing challenges, guys, as the entire industry is. You know who could make the difference? You. If you hit the join button below, it's gonna make all the difference and keep us in business. We appreciate you, thank you. Well, this goes along with Kennedy's strategy though, trying to appeal to both sides. And in this case, she's basically telling Republicans, come to our side. I don't know if she wants money from them, which is possible. And she's basically saying, wink, wink, nod, nod. We're actually working on your behalf. She's not saying, oh, we got a chance to win. And I can understand given the audience, but she's saying, if we wind up taking any blue states away from Biden, that's a giant gift to Donald Trump. And we're very happy to do that. So does she speak for the whole campaign? I don't know, but they do agree with Trump on, look, I've seen Kennedy say he disagrees with Biden on a bunch of things, right? Have I seen him aggressively say the things he doesn't agree with Donald Trump on? I haven't, but to be fair, maybe that didn't make the news. And I haven't watched everything that he said, right? But it's so, what's he famous for? The vaccine stuff, which is leans more Republican. So, and here is a top person in the campaign saying, oh, don't get it twisted. Like we want Trump to win if it's not us, at a minimum, right? And that's not that helpful. But I mean, look, both sides getting outraged at him is amusing to me. Yeah, he's running against you guys. So go ahead and be outraged all you want, but he's got a right to do that. And they're like, how come, like the Biden team's like, how come RFK Jr. isn't helping us? Because he's your opponent. So, and if he's secretly helping Trump, so what? So like that's his, he's got every right to do that. He's got a right to run on the right, and Cornel West, Jill Stein can run on the left. Whatever it is, whatever the trick that they're a scam, or if it's not a scam, or they just honestly believe it. And I think that RFK Jr. does honestly believe a lot of his positions, even if they're, you know, sometimes not perfectly rational. So then you give the voters a reason to vote for you. And like, what are we crying about Bobby Kennedy Jr.? You don't get to cry in politics. He's in the race, so beat him.
I just think that it's fascinating that this race is as close as it is between Biden and Trump. And the Democratic Party insisted on allowing Biden, who promised to only run for that one term, to run for re-election. Again, even though he promised not to. So we know that he's a vulnerable candidate. He insisted on running for re-election. And so we are where we are as a result of that. And I don't know what else to say. Are we supposed to, like, I get that people are terrified of Trump. And as a result, they want us to sit here and pretend like Biden's vulnerabilities don't exist. But they exist, whether we say it on this show or not. And so at what point does the DNC and the Democratic establishment take responsibility for their actions? That's what I want to know.
100%. And by the way, they created Bobby Kennedy Jr. in the first place. How do they do that? Because everyone who ran in the Democratic primary, which includes me in the past, in this cycle, they said, no, we're not interested in you. You have no chance of winning. We're never gonna let you win. In fact, we're gonna shut down a whole bunch of elections. Florida's not even gonna have an election, etc. We're not gonna have debates. You're not gonna get anything fair. We're not gonna give you access to the Democratic Party infrastructure. We're going to cheat 100% in favor of Joe Biden. So what happened? Bobby Kennedy Jr. left the Democratic Party and became a third party candidate. And now you're crying about it? Well, maybe you should have run a fair process. Biden would have probably beat, not probably, definitely would have beat Bobby Kennedy Jr. easily. He does, you know, the Democratic base doesn't agree with Bobby Kennedy on vaccines and other conspiracy theories, etc. And by the way, they did the same exact thing to Cornel West. And then Cornel West left the party and he became a third party candidate. And now that he's definitely gonna take votes away from Joe Biden. But it's the DNC's fault. Every time you go to run a primary inside the DNC, they're like, shut up, no elections, no debates, no nothing. We're gonna pick the candidate for you. By the way, in the general election, we're running on democracy's at risk. You have to vote for us. So spare me your crying about Bobby Kennedy Jr. Go out and do something for the voters. That's what you're supposed to do to win elections, but to them, that's like an unthinkable thing. They're like, all right, what else do we do for the donors? And how else do we block people from the Democratic Party? That way there'll be almost no one left in the Democratic Party. And then everybody will, wait, what? We'll vote for other people. Yeah, that, you idiots. Yes, this is exactly what's gonna happen when you run a primary that is rigged every single time in favor of the corporate politician that takes the most donor money.
So what did the campaign say about Rita Palma and the statements that she's been making? Well, they say they're not in favor of it. Rita Palma was hired a couple of weeks ago as a ballot access consultant responsible for scheduling volunteer shifts during our upcoming signature collection drive in the Empire State. She has no involvement in or access to electoral strategy nationally or in New York. And so they're trying to distance themselves from her and what she's been saying on the campaign trail. And so it is what it is. She says that she got hired after telling them that she refuses to be muzzled, that she wants to say what she wants to say. I don't know what actually transpired when the hiring process took place, but she's saying what she's saying. And I don't know if she's gonna persuade Republican voters to cast their ballots for RFK Jr. in these blue states. I find that strategy a little dubious to begin with, especially with deeply blue states. But this is what she's saying. And if you actually want to run on protecting democracy, you can't then go after third party candidates because they might skim some of the voters from you. But to be fair to Biden, I actually haven't seen much of that. Like, I haven't seen the Biden campaign go after RFK Jr. Maybe
no,
you have.
No. That's my point, yeah. Which is that they don't fight for policies that will affect your lives positively. And they barely even fight their opponents. They're always constantly leaking. Oh, press, do our job for us. Here's a little leak, leaky leak. Oh, and everybody yell at Bobby Kennedy, boo, and your family hates you, boo. How we use the mainstream press again. Oh, just be a man, okay? And go out there, and if you're gonna fight Bobby Kennedy, fight him. Punch him in the mouth, okay? I don't mean literally, obviously, I mean politically and rhetorically. Are you gonna fight Trump or are you gonna sit there all day, Joe Biden? No, he's gonna sit there on his stupid couch and say, everybody, I'm entitled to your vote. How dare Bobby Kennedy run against me? How dare he? And it turns out some of them, his supporters are right wing. How dare they? Because they genuinely believe that they're entitled to your vote and they don't have to do anything for it. And it's like, we serve them. No, brother, you're supposed to serve us. Last thing on this is the 270 thing. Don't get it twisted. Bobby Kennedy wins any of these states and they and nobody gets to 270, Republicans definitely win. Because in the House, they do not vote by seats, they vote by states. And the Republicans definitely control more states if it goes to this type of electoral situation. Thanks for watching The Young Turks, really appreciate it. Another way to show support is through YouTube memberships. You'll get to interact with us more. There's live chat, emojis, badges. You've got emojis of me, Anna, John, JR. So those are super fun. But you also get playback of our exclusive member only shows and specials right after they air. So all of that, all you gotta do is click that join button right underneath the video. Thank you.